I wanted to build a Iron Man project, a full suit of Iron Man for Halloween, so I can just walk around in school. I'm Ong-Yong Pong, I'm an engineering student. Currently, I'm doing my bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering in Taylor's University. In mechanical engineering, the practice is just so wide. I really like to see what I'm doing and I can physically touch and feel it. That's where I got into 3D printing and I realized like, hey, 3D printing can print very complex stuff. I think this one is monumental. I gotta show this. Yeah, it's some of the things I print. 3D printing, I think, is more hobbyist at the time. But as I learned deeper, the proper term is called additive manufacturing. I think at my semester 2 is where I got into contact with Dr. Chu, which is the program director. He was recruiting for engineers to compete in this competition for IES, which is Institute of Engineering Singapore. That's like the start of the journey of how I got into competitions. Alright, so in this shelf, let's start with the radiation shield. This one is the one that got into the Dubai Prototypes for Humanity last year. Very recently, just won the Enough Fest in Taylor's. So I got 1,000 ringgit from there. Second one, I think this one people are more familiar with. Introducing the Braille Pad. To make one Braille book, it takes up to 3,000 ringgit and 3 months to make. It's very expensive, so most of the visually impaired, they can't bring books home. So they can't even do basic self-study at home, which is like, wow, I need to make a change here. The main issue is because the production is too high cost and like time consuming. I do 3D printing, I do additive manufacturing. I can speed up the time by half. 5 years onwards, I'm looking to be one of the best engineers. I want to spend my life doing research, having conversation with the best of the best, every day performing at a very high level in terms of mind and brain. I think that's the dream.